Friends, Romans, countrymen, lend me your ear holes. hello, good evening and welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews with me, Terry Kay. We got a Williams Brothers. Oh, hold on, where are we? Shall I turn the light on? I'm in the dark again. Oh, we got the Williams Brothers there. If we can hide. Where you going? Here we go. There we go. The Williams Brothers from Aloha. From Aloha. I don't know why I keep saying it like that. I just think it's funny. There you go. And that is a Caesar Augustus. Now, both of them, Caesar and Augustus, are acquired names. For who we now kind of call Augustus, the Roman Emperor. He's... just show you all the, as I like to, all the kind of screen there, the screen, the label and everything. Now, yeah, Caesar Augustus, both acquired names, for Octavius, I've got to get his name right here, Gaius Octavius, God blimey, I'm bad enough with English names, where is it? Gaius Octavius Furinus. he got the name Caesar from Julius Caesar, which was kind of a posthumous kind of adoption. it was left in the will that he adopted him posthumously, you know, in Caesar's will. So after he got assassinated, that was in his will. Makes you kind of go, what's it? Because there was a lot of kind of jiggery pokery went on in them days, you know. But getting on quick and fast. Oh, we've got lager malt, hops, and yeast in this lager malt. Where was I? What was that? Yeah, lager malt. And the Augustus bit was. Where would that come from? Blimey, I was just reading this a minute ago. Oh yeah, it means the revered one. So, Caesar Augustus is kind of given roles, given names, but later to be known as Augustus, again posthumously. Right, crack it open, let's have a little taste. It says it's a Lager IPA hybrid. And yeah, from Bruce and Scott Williams, the Williams brothers. Let's give it a go. Shall I get me evil boys on? Let's get me evil boys on. I need to be evil. Because apparently, although it was Pax Romana, you know, the time of peace, was it 23 BC to 44 AD, something like that, I don't know. It was still a lot of stuff going on in it, you know. It wasn't quite the peaceful land that it suggested. Here we go. One of my favourite songs just come on. I'm watching Kerrang. Look at that. Isn't that beautiful? Right, anyway, I'm not watching Kerrang, I'm watching you guys out here. Pouring in the Blackfriars just in case he's a little bit too popsy McLagery. Because whenever I hear the word lager, apart from certain times, you know, like the Gould lager, or God lager if you like, but Gould lager from Niels Oscar, that was marvellous, and it actually tasted kind of lagery, but it was brilliant. And then you've got the absolutely marvellous Brooklyn Lager, but that's a fruit punch bowl, you know, it's that's really lovely as well. And you've got Pivovar, Utenos, things like that. And also, something that I would almost call a lager is the Fuller's Summer Ale, which is made with Saiz hops, you know, a famous Czech lager hop. So, let's pour it and see how we go with this. I always kind of, the minute I hear anything lager or anything like that, I think what it is, the reason they probably call it a hybrid is they're probably using lager malts and lager hops, but not lager yeast, so it won't be a bottom feeder, it'll be feeding on the top. And but I don't know, it doesn't actually say, does it? We use the term lager lager IPA hybrid because we cold ferment this beer with a classic lager yeast. So this is cold fermented, which the lager yeast, they like that, you know. The initial fermentation takes at least 2 weeks, after which we lager or store the beer at 0 degrees. 0 degrees? For a minimum of 4 weeks, during which period we add a chock load of classic IPA style hops and allow the two to marry. Fanfare! It says fanfare on it. I added the fanfare, obviously. It's not got a load of notes. Oh, scratching my leg. Right, let's smell and see how we go. Oh, well, it smells lovely. You're getting fruity hops here. It doesn't smell like they're being overdone. It smells fruity, but it smells light as well. I thought I could trust these boys, because the Williams brothers, they seem to... especially so, it seems, with their bottles. Because I had Williams Brothers at the GBBF, and it was lovely. But for me, I've had so much joy out of their bottles. The Frake, the alcoholic ginger beer, and hopefully now this one, you know. Anyway, let's have a little, one more sniff, and then here we go. Yeah, you're getting kind of orangey notes there. You're getting tangerines. You're getting... this is going to sound really, really like Poncy, one of these Poncy ones. But kumquats. You're getting kumquats. Taste them. You get them in a lot of beers. It's worth tasting them. Kumquats. Look at me. Turned into a bit of a wine ponce, didn't I? But here you go. Let's have a taste. Oh, that is lovely. That is, that is a joy. That is a joy. There's a tiny little bit of bittering going on. Just enough bittering. And then you've got all these lovely, lush little fellas all dancing around. There's not too much fruitiness. It's not kind of down to the fruit section you've got to go, you know. It's not down to there. It's kind of a little bit of fruitiness, a little bit of this and that going on. It's really gorgeous, it's really nice. Oh, that is lovely. It's refreshing. I don't think this will be one of them that ain't a shock again. I'm always looking for those that just can just get the Popsy McLager boys and go, have a taste of this, try that. You know, you do that with some of the other beers and they go, oh, it's got flavour. You know, they're not used to it, you know. With this, it's got that flavour, but it's just nice and lightly done, and that is superb. It really is. Well, Williams Brothers, boys, you have done it again. You have done it again. Guys and girls, go out and buy that one. Buy it and try it. That one's a Caesar Augustus. I love the name. I'm not quite sure where you get the name from. Where that ties in with a lager and IPA hybrid or whatever, but pardon me, it is absolutely superb. Anyway, thank you very much, Caesar Augustus, hail the owl, and cheers to beers. Cheers. Bye. Oh, it's lovely.